Hello and welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes, Cooking with JB. Today I'm going to make a Cajun style chicken and sausage jambalaya. It's a favorite down here. And there's many ways to make a jambalaya, or different styles of meat, or different ways. You can make it Creole style by adding tomatoes, but or seafood. But we're not gonna do that. I'm just gonna do a standard Cajun one pot version, and it's a great meal. So let's get started. I got some chicken thighs right here that I just washed by putting them inside of one of them zipper freezer bags with some water, and then dumped it out in the zinc. And the reason I done that is so I didn't splash water, raw chicken water all over my sink and contaminate it. And I'm gonna put these in a 350 degree oven on roast mode for about 45 minutes till that skin crisps up. I'm gonna flip them, put them skin side up after I season them heavily with salt and pepper. I've got them elevated on a cake cooling rack. Now I've got some Cajun sausage, Cajun smoked sausage, that I cut somewhat on a bias to help it get more surface contact in the pot. Let's go ahead and brown this. Spread them out in a single layer if you can. You may have to do it in batches if you're making a lot. My hands are clean, I just washed them in the zinc. Now it's cooked on both sides. I flipped it, and it's ready. Let's pull it out of here and drain some of this grease out. So we're finna get more grease in here from that chicken. Okay, this chicken is ready. Been roasting for 45 minutes and his skin is crispy, and I'm not gonna put it in a jambalaya. I'll eat it on the side. It's called chicken bacon. I'm gonna remove it. The chicken's hot right now though. So let me remove that, and I need some of this chicken grease down from there in here. So let's add that baked chicken grease, and we're gonna deglaze this too. Okay, here's that chicken skin. Protect this with your life. Don't let nobody else have it. It's chef's privilege right there. Let's go ahead and add some Cajun Trinity. This is buy it in the store frozen. It is chopped onions, bell pepper, and celery. And let's give that a little brown, and we're gonna put some garlic in here. Homemade concentrated chicken stock. Now this is a very important step. We're gonna add 1 cup of water. You could use chicken stock if you'd like, but you've already made it and put it in there. We're gonna take that chicken apart, and put it in there so it's boneless, or you can just throw it in whole. It don't matter. And we're gonna add 1 cup of long grain rice, extra long grain or long grain. If you use medium grain or short grain, this ain't gonna come out right. This is an important step. Now the chicken wasn't completely cooked. It still had ice crystals in it when I got it out the fridge. So it's finishing cooking right now in that boiling water. Okay, the chicken's all cooked. Got 2 cups of water in there. And I got 1 cup of long grain rice. Extra long grain. Matter of fact, and this is a very important step left out of many, many recipes. Your chicken must be cooked, and you must use long grain rice. And you've got to reduce the heat to low simmer. Cover this for 20 minutes. Don't mess with it. Don't lift the lid. Set a timer, 20 minutes. Don't peek, don't leave it alone. If you do, you're gonna screw it up. So once it's ready, let's go ahead and fluff it up. And eat. Nice little jambalaya here. All your vegetables are in there. Just eat, make some bread on the side. Now after 20 minutes, just shut the heat off. Don't open the pot. Let it sit for about 5 minutes or so, depending on the size of the pot. Then you're ready for a fine meal. And that chicken skin bacon is delicious. Oh, yum. Oh, yeah. You can also make a pasta layer by just substituting the rice for pasta. I'll make a wiener jambalaya, hot dog jambalaya. There's a party-sized pot, or small party size, anyway. Here's a 25-gallon pot of pasta layer. Yeah, so there's many different variations on jambalaya. You can actually make it with squirrel and or alligator. Any kind of meat, any kind of game meat you want, you can put in a jambalaya. The most popular down here is like sold in restaurants and things like that. We even have some places that specifically sell jambalaya. That's all they did, with sides. And they would have things like ham or pork in sausage jambalaya, or chicken jambalaya only. So you can select from different flavors. And a Creole jambalaya would normally have tomatoes in it and possibly seafood. Most restaurants don't serve it like that because the seafood's so expensive, and people know jambalaya is very inexpensive and cheap to make. So, and it doesn't keep well. Matter of fact, you've got a jambalaya will not keep till the next day. You've got to eat it that day or throw it out. It gets sour from sitting covered, closed, in a closed container. You could freeze it, but I ain't eating it. Common sides that we have with this is just bread. You could have cornbread if you'd like. You could have French bread. You could have little rolls. Other sides would be like white beans are very popular. A little green salad, tossed salad. I like black-eyed peas, so that's what I use.